Hey guys, it's Adam aka Swimming Bird, and welcome back to the Minecraft Hardcore Adventure Challenge. This is where we play on permadeath, hardcore, in a 174 world, but we are stuck in adventure mode, so we cannot break blocks without the right tool for the job. I am here in the plains. I found a fresh plains biome. I think it might even be sunflower plains, because we got some sunflowers here. But I found a pod of horses, or a herd, whatever you want to call them. I'm sure there's like a very specific name for just a group of horses. A ransackle or something weird. But anyways, oh, where did he go? Oh no! So this is the horse that I want. There's three normal ones here. That one is white legs, that's kind of nice. But this one has spots, and I really wanted this one. But now, it's actually stuck down here. I'm gonna build a little thing for it to get back up, because I wanted to tame that one. So it took me a really long time to find this. If you guys remember last time, I was in a jungle. I'm actually pretty close by. I went back to my house, stopped by, I had to feed Jeremiah, and gave him a chicken or something. But he, be very careful, come here. I got a name for this, but I want to make sure that it won't just jump off. I think if I try to tame it, then it will walk toward, like, it won't just walk off the side. Oh, it does! Okay, this is walking off the side. Well, if we can tame it, we might be able to make that jump. So anyways, let's try this here. It looked like that block almost broke. This is the one I want. This is the pony that I have marked as my destiny. We're gonna bond, and I'm gonna ride this baby home. I have a couple saddles, so I could get another one, but I don't have a lead. I haven't seen any slimes yet. So, I mentioned I went back home. Ooh, this guy does not have that much health. I should be very careful on this one. Did I get him? I don't know. He's still just kind of sitting around. There we go. I can pop a saddle on this one. Can you take saddle? Yeah, you can. Okay. So if this does happen to not work out, I could probably take this saddle off. There we go. This is my first survival horse I've ever gotten. Pretty crazy. Or adventure horse, I should say. We're going to take this guy and head over to the jungle again, because I would like to get a cat as well. No luck on wolves still, guys. I'm still working on getting a wolf. It's just very tough finding them for some reason. They're always in the forest, so it's harder to see them than horses. Horses, it's a little easy to spot them. There we go. Just have to time that jump right. And we are out. All right. This one seems a little fast. It's just, its health is so low. I'm gonna need some horse armor. I should have brought some with me. I'm gonna try to remember. These guys might despawn, but I'm sticking with this one. This is the one. It's a fearless horse that dove into a ravine. So I feel like this is the horse for me. I'm gonna name this one Pumpernickel. I think that's a good name for a horse, a strong horse name. So let's head over this way. I think on the other side of this taiga, we might be able to spot the jungle. I'm trying to remember which direction it is. It was around here. If we keep our eyes to the taiga, we might spot a wolf, if I'm lucky. But yeah, this is mainly, I'm keeping my eyes open for Enderman once it becomes night, because that's really our main goal here. We got to get a few more Ender Pearls. I've got a couple eyes of Ender, but not enough to to get us into the stronghold. I got to find it too, so we're going to need extra ones. But yeah, we're just working our way to the end of the game, trying to get some more pets and stuff. I'd like a wolf to help me fight some Endermen. I just gotta be very careful. At least this will negate some of my fall damage if I fall. I'm just a little worried because Pumpernickel's health is so low. Only 6 hearts, that seems, or 7 hearts, that seems really low for a horse. I don't think the jungle is this way. I'm gonna keep looking here. But yeah, we're looking for a cat. That is the goal. And I don't have a lead to tie Pumpernickel up, so if he's too wild, I gotta be very careful. Might escape and go, you know, try to find a mate. He's a wild Mustang that needs to be free, but I've tamed him, and I've tamed his heart. I'm gonna find the jungle real quick, and then we'll be right back. There we go. Okay, Pumpernickel, we found the jungle. I forgot that horses can dash, so this is speeding him up quite a bit. I didn't realize how, like, he was. I think I got a pretty bad horse. I know I said he's wild and untamed. I'm loyal. I'm not gonna abandon a horse just because it only has 7 hearts and, you know, can't run all that fast. This is still faster and less, you know, food taxing than jogging on my own. So I'm gonna stick with this one, for sure, until it dies at least. And then I will take its saddle and maybe get another one. I hope not. It's gonna be tragic if I spend a lot of time trying to find pets and then they die. So we're gonna go through this jungle a little bit if we can. Uh-oh, I'm gonna get kicked off here if I go too deep. I forgot about that. But the main goal right now is to find a cat. I would like to protect my base, if possible, from creepers coming in. But the wolves are really what I want to find. I've actually done a lot of traveling off camera. I mentioned I went back to the base. I've been collecting all the stray sugarcane I could find. I'm pretty close to having the right amount of bookcases to build a nice little enchantment table setup. I do need the diamonds, so if we can find like a jungle temple, that would be amazing. One of the things I wanted to talk about today, I've been thinking about 1.8 a lot. I know last week's snapshot, it was some cool things, well, a lot of cool things, but the problem was a lot of people weren't as interested because we got a lot of commands and things for map makers, and we keep getting that sort of stuff. And I do wonder if making some of that stuff seems to be a bit more interesting to the developers than some of the survival things. So I'm still hopeful that we're going to get more survival stuff, but it got me thinking, like, what would be the best or even, like, easiest thing that they could add to survival that would greatly benefit the game? And I was thinking about the Minecraft players out there. We got the people who like to build and sometimes use creative. A lot of people like playing survival, but, you know, there's only so much you can do in survival. The world is limitless, and the terrain generation, you know, you can find some cool stuff. But there's still, you know, a limit to the interest in what stuff you can find, since a lot of the temples and things have they have the same layout for the most part, unless they glitch generating. Look at these crazy flowers. We're in a flower forest, I think, here. But yeah, it's like, there's so much variation to the terrain, that's what we need. Hello, I'm gonna walk over to this water, so that if he comes up behind me, I'll go in the water. The only problem is I can lose these guys sometimes if they go in the water, and if they walk in there, then I can, got a little spike there. But yeah, if they go in the water, they will go passive again. And you don't want that, because then you can lose them. But I also don't want him to kill me. Where'd he go? I'm using the new Optifine. We have a 1.7.4 version of Optifine now, so, ooh, an apple. So yeah, things aren't as laggy. If you saw the end of the last one, we got a bit of lag. I think I lost him, guys. I also got to keep tabs on Pumpernickel over here. But yeah, the lag is a lot nicer now that and less now that I've got my Optifine going here. Generating new terrain in 1.7 just seems to slow the game down a lot, even with a high-end computer. But yeah, I was mentioning, so they've been adding a lot of things for map makers and some, you know, new blocks for building and things like that. I think ideally if they could somehow make the game appeal to builders and, you know, survival players at the same time, that would be best, you know, because you want to please all different groups. And one of the best things I can think that I would enjoy them doing, and I think a lot of people would enjoy is, ooh, did I just hear the Enderman? Is going through the new biomes. We got all these new biomes in 1.7. Some of them have things to go for, like if you want Podzol, you can go to the Mega Taiga. If you want the new woods, you can go to the new, you know, is he hitting? No! Ah, Pumpernickel! Skeleton just shot Pumpernickel. I just heard some creepiness. Whoa. Got a little turned around there. Pumpernickel, be careful. I got some wheat and stuff I think I can feed. And I also have an apple. Aw, yeah. No! Get away from me, zombie. I gotta protect my horse. But yeah, we got all these new biomes, and a few of them have, you know, reasons to go there block-wise, like some new building blocks. I noticed very few of them have new actual survival reasons other than for building or decoration. There's a few things that, you know, we got new flowers and stuff like that, but not as much, like, loot and those types of things to go there. We have the temple, like the jungle temple and the desert temple and stuff like that, the pyramids and everything. Those are good starts, I believe, but like, I would like to see not only new versions of that for all the new biomes and things like variations in that, but I'd also like to see variations even within those structures. And because the first time you go to a jungle temple, there's that trap in there. There's a couple traps with tripwire and stuff that can screw you up. I'm trying to get away from some of these monsters. They can screw you up, but then once you learn how they work, you can disarm them pretty easily. I gotta get down to where I can just go through, because yeah, you can run your horse through these leaves as long as it's under it. But yeah, you get these traps. They're kind of scary at first, but once you know how to disarm them, the TNT trap in the jungle temple, or the pyramid, sorry, the desert temple is very similar. Once you learn how it works, it's not as scary. And I think they need to have some variation, like if they had a variation of how those traps worked, where those traps are placed, that type of thing, it would make those temples a lot more exciting and compelling. And the other thing, we've gotten a few more easy ways now, like being able to craft the mossy cobblestone, the mossy stone brick. There is a spider jockey. I'm going to go after him and leave Pumpernickel there for a sec. I need to feed Pumpernickel. Here we go. I think I can feed him wheat, correct? Eat this. There we go. He's healed. Okay. Let me grab this. I got my milk, even though I don't need it that much here, but I had it for the wither skeletons, just in case. I have a ton of arrows, because I was grinding some gravel and getting some chickens. Uh-oh. He's coming at me. Kill him. Spider's not too bad once I get the jockey off of there. Oh, he stuck over my head. That was really weird. But yeah, I think just that we have all these new biomes. I think the thing that would make them more enjoyable is just having reasons to go to them. I like exploring, and even if someone doesn't like exploring that much, they might be compelled to go to those new biomes if there was more reasons. Like, we have a couple new blocks in there, but for the most part, there's not that much. So I think a new mob, having each biome have something new for several types of players would be ideal. Like, each biome could have a loot item that is only found there. Each, could have a block. A lot of them do have blocks that are only found there already. And maybe even a mob or mob variation. I mentioned this before, but there are some resource packs that reskin different, use variations on skinning some of the animals and monsters in the game so they look different. And having the swamp have like a pig that's a boar when you're there, like having it spawn in and it chooses the texture based on which biome it spawns in could be really cool. So if someone is, you know, just interested in collecting all these different species of animals too, that would be a way to make it more interesting to go there. Like little things, I'm trying to think of things that wouldn't be that hard for them to add, because I know they're apprehensive about adding new mobs at this point. I think they're a little burnt out from the horse. Whoa, hey buddy, Pumpernickel, get up here. Don't drown, please. I gotta get him out of there. Whoa, my mouse is going weird. Okay, yeah, I'm keeping my eyes open for cats, but this is very dangerous. There we go, okay, there's one. Pumpernickel, stay there. Hope that creeper doesn't follow me all the way over here. I have several different types of fish, and I'm gonna grab them all. The cats will actually eat the poison blowfish, which is kind of funny. Seems like you wouldn't want to feed that. I'm gonna start with that for the cat. But yeah, they think they can eat this, and they have some immunity to the blowfish somehow. I think I see an enderman, too. I better get this zombie out of here. He's gonna interrupt me taming this cat. But yeah, once I have a cat, if I can get it back to my base, that would be a nice protection from creepers. Here we go. Here, little kitty. There's an enderman freaking out. Eat this. One, two. Yes! Oh, it's a Tum-Tums. the little tuxedo cat looks like my cat, Mr. Tum-Tums. He's waiting patiently for another Wild World adventure. Hopefully we'll get back to that sometime here. We've got some more doing to get the rest of these animals, because I do, and monsters, I would like to update the zoo sometime here, so we'll have to work on that. Alright, let's go back for Pumpernickel. I got my cat. As long as both of these animals survive, I'm happy with this journey. Finding a wolf would be amazing as well. My mouse keeps getting locked in weird positions. I don't know what's going on here. Let me jump on Pumpernickel if I can. It's gonna boot me. Oh, I just gotta slowly edge Pumpernickel over. Come on, Pump. All right, I'm gonna try to get Pumpernickel out of the water, and we'll be right back. All right, we're going again. I got Pumpernickel out. If I can find my way through here, hopefully, he needs a name. I don't know. I can't name him Mr. Tum-Tums because that's, you know, obviously taken. Could name him like Tum-Tums Jr. or something. How about you guys leave some cat name suggestions? I know I asked this last time, but I'm looking for a good cat name. I thought about the horse names, and I was like, maybe a bread theme would be kind of funny. So if I do get more horses, I might name them after breads as well. But yeah, I don't know about a good, you know, I could try to have you guys help me with a theme for cats. Come on, buddy. Yeah, his best jump is, like, slightly above a couple blocks. I have to really hit that orange marker there. Uh-oh. We are really high. I need to be careful. Pumpernickel, oh, look out! Was that him or me that got hit? There we go. At least the creepers will hopefully stay away. No, he's okay. Creepers will hopefully stay away now that I have my little cat, unnamed cat, with me. So let's head through here. There we go. But yeah, I need to keep my eyes open for wolves. But anyways, 1.8, so far, we're getting into that point where they keep adding commands and tweaking stuff, and I'm hoping that doesn't mean they're winding down on development. We don't really have a very clear theme so far. Sorry about these jumps. There we go. Just gotta get into the orange, and it will be good. And I think we're heading out of this jungle is huge. We're heading towards water. Gotta be very careful. Pumpernickel does not like water. But yeah, like, the theme of 1.8, I don't know what you would say it is so far. There is a lot of commands and map maker stuff, but that, you know, that happens every update. They kind of add a lot of that type of thing. I got some watermelon back home if I need it. I can go through this shallow water. I just got to be careful. Let's head this way and make sure I'm heading towards home. We might actually be heading deeper out, but that's okay too. I don't really mind. I want to explore. I'm really looking for a village as well. The last world I did on here had a village right there, so it was really convenient. But this one, I have no signs of it. I've only found like two plains biomes, and the second one I found had this pod of horses or whatever. I need to look up what horses are called. A group of them. Probably just a herd or something. I like ramsackle. That's a cool little word. But yeah, we gotta push Pumpernickel over and ford this river. The theme of 1.8, I would love to see it pushed more towards survival, but who knows if we're gonna go that way. I know a lot of people aren't as, yeah, like I mentioned, they're not as interested in a lot of the updates if they don't affect the way that they play the game normally, like, but, I mean, any update, as long as it improves the game or adds some feature that is useful that we haven't gotten yet, is welcome by me. But I do agree with those people, it's not as interesting when it's stuff that's cool, but you can't get, you know, do in a normal game, like commands and stuff. So, we'll have to see. I like playing adventure maps, so it is nice when they add stuff to that. I'm a little worried still about the adventure update, where we can't use anything in adventure mode unless it's specifically tagged. Pumpernickel, I just hit a perfect jump and he's not jumping on here. I think he's not very good in the water. But yeah, I think 1.8 is promising. I'd like to see a clearer theme develop. I was hoping it was going to be another adventure-y update. Not adventure map, but adventure like adventuring in Minecraft type of thing. More mobs, that sort of thing. I think that was when we got like the most mobs back when 1.7, 1.8, when we had the old version, where that was like the huge stuff with all the beta, getting like Enderman and Silverfish and all that cool stuff. I'd love to see something like that again, where they go crazy with new monsters and stuff like that, because that would definitely spice up the game and get me to want to explore and go out again. So anyways, thank you guys for watching. I'm going to probably head towards home now that I've got some of these pets. Keeping my eyes open for wolves. Please leave a name for my little cat, as long as he's still behind me. Are you there, buddy? Where'd you go? Meow. I need to hear his meow. It comforts me. Is he's in the tree. Okay, there he is. He's okay. Let's keep going. I'm going to head onward. Thanks for watching, guys. Please leave a like if you enjoyed this. And a little kiss for you there. Mwah. I'll see you guys next time for more of the Hardcore Adventure Challenge. Goodbye.